We welcome in Brian Munz at Bell MTS Place. We remember these teams playing for the West Championship. They go at it tonight for the first time since that series. What was the mood like today in both rooms heading into this contest?
Well, Tony, I think for the most part, there was more conversation about it inside the Winnipeg room than there was for the Golden Knights. Obviously, for the team in Winnipeg that came short last year in Game 5, they want to show that they can beat this club. There's no question the best of seven series prior to the Western Final that the Jets had to go through with the Nashville Predators wore them down. And you could tell it wasn't the game that they wanted to play. But give a lot of credit to Marc-Andre Fleury, what he was able to do in that series. He'll get the start here for the Golden Knights. And Vegas is playing with a lot of confidence right now. They've had only one regulation loss in their last 10. They've been able to turn things up here, and for that matter, Winnipeg has as well. So as these two teams come in here for the first of three matchups this season, there's a lot of hype inside the building for sure.
As there should be. Let's follow up on Flower and the Golden Knights coming in hot. 8 wins in the club's last 10 games. What's the key for the Jets to disrupt Vegas's hot streak tonight?
Well, when you talk to a lot of the Golden Knight players and they practiced here inside Bell MTS Place yesterday afternoon, they just like the overall game they have right now. And to a man, everybody outside of himself, Marc-Andre Fleury is crediting for what they've been able to do here with his hot play. Obviously, getting Nate Schmidt on the back end has been huge for them defensively. Missed the first 20 games, and Gerard Gallant again said today for the second consecutive day that you look at number 88 and how big he has been for this club on the back end, and they've been getting some pretty good depth scoring here despite the fact they've got no Riley Smith and a few other players that have been out of the lineup here right now. So there's a lot of confidence inside that room for sure.
There's got to be confidence in Laurent Brossoit because he's getting the start in net for the Jets. 9-0-1 as a starter. How has he been able to do this considering he doesn't play consistently?
Well, that's the million-dollar question right now that I guess for Winnipeg people, they don't want to solve because he's been that good. And really, you know, when you look at it, Tony, it dates back to training camp. He came in here with the right mindset. Things weren't very good for him last year with the Edmonton Oilers and looked at this as a new lease on life. And he's been tremendous all the way through the preseason and now the regular season games that he's been involved with. And you talk about the lack of games that he's played in the regular season schedule so far because this is Connor Hellebuck's team. He has come in here and just done a world-class effort for the club. And I guess the game that everybody looks at was the last game that he played right before Christmas in his home province in Vancouver. He was able to shut out the Canucks. I think it was 40 saves on that night that he was able to beat Vancouver with. And really, since that time, whenever he's been tapped on the shoulder here, there's been a pretty good level of confidence inside that room. So along with that game in Vancouver, this might be the biggest test that Laurent Brossoit will get as a member of the Winnipeg Jets tonight.
Hockey fans will be watching. It's going to be a great one. Thanks for joining us, Brian Munz.